What's going on, bro? It's 7:50 p.m. Miami, Florida. Pretty clear, calm night. I just got back from a walk. But I was thinking, you know, I was walking back without my phone just to get some clear thought. And I was really just thinking that sometimes you gotta just make it happen, bro. Sometimes you gotta just make it happen. And you gotta stop waiting for it to happen. Because if you stay your entire life waiting for it to happen, man, you're gonna be waiting a long time, my friend. You're gonna see all your friends go do what they want with their lives, go see your siblings, everyone in your family, and then you're gonna still be there waiting for it to happen, thinking that you're entitled for it to happen, bro. You don't deserve that. If you're waiting for it to happen, do you really think you deserve success? Like, be real with yourself. Compared to if you're putting that work, if you're doing the best to elevate, wouldn't you say you deserve success? Like, at least more likely than when you were doing nothing. I want you to think, like, when you were going to the gym, bro, for the first year or two, like, for me, I was a super skinny kid, 100 pounds, like, no confidence, couldn't fill out my shirts. I was the skinniest kid, like, in my grade, bro. Like I wouldn't eat. And I knew that this would be a hard thing. Like, people said, Alex, why are you trying so hard, bro? You're a skinny kid. You can't ever build muscle. And now I'm sitting around here at 190 pounds, and people are like, Alex, how'd you do it? I say that to make you realize that, you know, when I was starting the first year or two, bro, I didn't see progress. I didn't see anything. I didn't see anything happening. I thought I was wasting my time. My mom said, focus on school, stop buying this protein powder and start eating more vegetables and blah, blah, blah. And I just stuck to it, bro. I just said, you know what? What's the worst thing that could happen? I could learn how to, you know, become a better lifter in the gym, even if it doesn't go my way. But what I realized was that I was creating inputs, whether I knew it or not. I was going to the gym, eating, sleeping, becoming better, and naturally the outputs are going to come, like anything in life, bro. You got to realize that if you put inputs in, outputs are going to happen. Now, it might not be today, tomorrow, or next week, but they're going to come eventually, right? And so even though that was a hard journey, you know, 6 years now I've been lifting, like, it doesn't feel hard, bro, because I just focused on one day at a time. You know, I don't know about you, but in my house here, like, if I'm trying to go to the second floor, I don't go step 1 to step 20. I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so on and so forth up till 20. Like, it takes time, bro. Nothing comes quick. At least nothing good. Most things that come up quick go down quick too. The best things in life are when you stick to it, even though you don't know if it's going to work out. But you just keep going. You keep believing. You have faith that if you're doing your best, God's going to help you do the rest, bro. Like, that's been my mindset for so long now. And I realized that if I'm going to be in this grind, if I'm going to be in this struggle phase where I don't know if I'm going to make it, I might as well fall in love with it. I might as well start to love the grind. I got to go hard, so I might as well go hard, loving the grind. Loving getting up at 6 a.m., loving getting 4 meals a day, loving hitting legs when I don't want to, love not hitting the snooze button, love saying, nah, sorry, boys, I would love to go out with y'all on a Friday night, but I gotta focus on me, I gotta self-improve, I gotta do this stuff that I said I was gonna do, right? You gotta realize that nothing's gonna happen, at least nothing new, if nothing changes. You gotta make that change for yourself. When I stopped playing 2K, when I stopped, you know, like, playing Xbox, I was one of the first of my boys to, like, stop. But now they all stopped. And it's like, do you want to be the first to leave or the last to leave? And if you're the last to leave, it's like, you got no one left to play with. You got no one left to play with. So many of you all are focused on building your NBA 2K My Career character, building your fantasy world when you're a 50 overall in real life, bro. Like, something's got to change, my friend. Something's got to change. You know, every time I failed in my life, every time something didn't go my way, it could have been the reason I stopped. I could have said, you know what, bro? Like, I didn't get the thing I wanted to. Now I'm going to stop. But I realized that when I failed, when I put myself out there and I tried to do my best, even though it didn't work out most of the time, I'm still here. I'm still here. I'm still alive. I'm still doing good. And now at least I learned something from that. Because you never learn something when everything's going right. You only learn when things go wrong. And just like that, like, if you were given everything that you wanted in life at 14, at 16, like a dream car, your dream apartment, your dream girl, every one of those things that you want, bro, you wouldn't appreciate it. You wouldn't appreciate the grind. It wouldn't mean anything to you. Now, like I said, going from step 1 to step 20, like, I'm living here, Miami, Florida. I'm so proud because I was on my feet. I came here when I was 17. I knew no one. And now I have a business going. I'm a student. I have a great physique. I got a car. Like, I got beautiful people in my life. All that stuff took time, and I'm not where I want to be. I'm not where I'm going to be. But I'm better than I used to be, right? I'm not as good as I want to be. I'm not as great as I'm gonna be, but I'm better than I used to be, right? That's the mindset, bro. You gotta have that mindset. You gotta have that belief in you, dog. A lot of young men feel lost in the world today, and I feel like, yes, but it's a lot harder to feel lost in the world when you got a routine, when you know exactly what you need to do to get to that goal. You know, a man who has no vision always returns to his past. So if you want to change your life, you got to start with a routine. You got to start with a game plan, because if you know what to do, it becomes easier, right? The motivation, like everything you're doing. Think of it like building a house, bro. It's hard to know how to build a house. Hard to be consistent with that, to be motivated with that, if you don't have a game plan, if you don't have a blueprint. But if you have the blueprint and you're showing up to work every single day, it's like, yeah, like I got to do this, whatever. It's going to cost what it's going to cost. Am I going to put in the work? Hell yeah. Because I want to build the house. I want to build my future. I want to build my life. Every time in my life where I've been like inconsistent and where I've thought I was going to slip, bro, I always come back to like getting back on the grind. I always get back in the fight. Now there might be timeouts in a football game, but the show's going to go on, bro. And I'm going to get back in that fight, get back in that game. And even if I don't know what I'm going to do, I'm going to try to find the open receiver, bro. You feel me? Like, it's crazy for me to think about that, because it's like, I sometimes, bro, I'm like, I've had it. I've had this. This sucks. This fucking sucks. I don't know if I can keep going. I don't know if I want to keep going, because it's like I'm not seeing the progress, bro. I'm putting my work in. I'm trying hard, but I'm not seeing anything. It's like, okay, you can quit and you won't get any further, or you can keep going. If you stop right now, like, nothing's going to change. And so that's always what leaves me back to it, bro. That's always what leaves me coming back, because I realize, like, if I stop right now, why should my life improve? And I'm so proud of, like, doing this. Everything that I'm doing, you know, I'm recording videos and all this stuff. Like, obviously, I want to share the love, like, inspire you, bro. But it's for me, too. I want to see the progress. I want to see me going from a 16-year-old when I started shooting content, when I had a squeaky voice and, like, I didn't know what I was doing in the gym, whatever. And now I'm, like, this becoming this man. I'm slowly turning into the person I always wanted to become. And that shit is fulfilling, bro. That's why I say for anyone, do YouTube, do social media. And you gotta have a good balance with it, because for me personally, I only come onto social media to post these days, because I don't think there's any good in scrolling, bro. Like, for me, like, all my knowledge I'm getting is through, like, books and stuff, bro, which is a lot better, because it's just, like, less stimulus. It's just, like, a very basic activity. But because I've been posting, I've fallen in love with the grind even more, because I can see the progress. Because it's like going to the gym, you know, if I would have taken myself at, like, 14, 15 when I started lifting to now at 21 years old, and I wouldn't have any progress photos, I wouldn't have any transformation videos, anything, I'd be like, you know what, I look better in the mirror, but like, it's not that drastic. But since I have those photos, bro, I can see myself go from 110 to 190 pounds, go from a 85 pound squat to like 350 pounds. Like, that shit inspires me, and that makes me keep going. Because I know that person, when I was 14, when I was 15, starting my grind of improvement, trying to read and like get better at certain things, I didn't know where it was going, but I knew that 21-year-old Alex would probably be doing those things, and I would want to make him proud so it's easier on him. Because you don't realize it, bro, but like, you're going to be the same person you are now. A little bit wiser, hopefully, a little bit smarter, a little bit more wisdom, a little bit stronger. But you're going to be the same person. You are the person who has unique gifts. Like, that's you. That is you. And now your image of yourself might change, but you might not change. Let me rephrase that. The image, you are going to be the same person, but your image might change because you've done stuff in that time. And so just keep focusing. It's like, think about, like, down the line, like, what would you tomorrow want you today to do? And I know that for me today, on Sunday, September 29th in Miami, Florida, I wanted to read my book, did that. I wanted to eat four meals, did that. I wanted to go to the gym, did that. I wanted to record a video, did that. And it's like, I don't have to do this, but I know tomorrow me would want me to do it, so it's easier on him. Do you know what I'm saying? Like, if you can think of it, don't do it for you. Don't be selfish. Think of it for tomorrow, you. It's going to be easier, because tomorrow is going to have its own set of problems, bro. You already know that. Tomorrow, you never know what's going to happen. There could be a great day. It could be a bad day. Like, life is just going to happen as it does. But if you do those things today, when you don't feel like it, bro, to make it easier for tomorrow, you'll be way ahead. And then when tomorrow's problems come, you're, like, ready to face it, bro. Like, think about that. You gotta stop caring that mental picture of yourself as that depressed, worthless person, bro, because you're not. You're building yourself, you're figuring yourself out as every single person in this world is, my G. As I've said before, I really don't believe it's about knowing what to do. I think it's just showing up. Continuing to put shots up, continuing to go up to the plate and swing away, because like the only time you strike out in life, bro, is when you don't even go up to the plate. If you strike out, like, who cares? You're at least doing it, you're trying it. And then people will talk from the crowd like, hey, you suck. But it's like, bro, like, I don't even need to argue with those people because I'm doing stuff and they ain't. They ain't even trying. So I know it's tough. I know it's tough, bro. I know life can be fucking tough. But expand the time horizon. Don't think tomorrow, think in 2 years. Think if you go to the gym every single day for 2 years, you post content, you read books, you're gonna become a lot better. Because in the micro, you might not see the progress, but in the macro, bro, I promise you, you're gonna see the progress. I got this guy right here on my wall. This lion over here, right? And I look at this guy because he's always staring at me when I'm here at my desk, you know, on my computer and doing stuff. And I see that despite life, like all the crazy stuff that's happening in the world, bro's always looking at me, keeping the same stoic posture and just looking back at me. And it's like, yeah, like that's it, bro. Just look back at life and just keep going. I look at him and I'm like, you know what? I could quit, but would he quit? Probably not. So that's what I got. Just spin what's on my mind. Like I said, I got back from a walk without my phone just because I wanted to get a break, disconnect. And when you go on those walks, bro, without your phone, like you got to try it. Magical stuff happens because you're just thinking. You're actually having time to think. And I want you to think, like, how often do you actually have time to just think? Just your thoughts. Think of things that you like to think about, things that you like to do. Not a lot in this world, bro. And so, yeah, that's what I got, boys. Keep pushing. Let's get to the top. It's all love. And yeah, I'll talk to y'all in the next video. Peace out.